Once again, I had to head away from the main event. The Imperial Navy had already sealed off our course to Australia as they routed Java. A British fleet had deployed in the Gulf of Bengali. We arranged to RV at an island northwest of our position. To get us there in one piece, I decided to use nature to hide us. We'd travel there under the cover of a storm. By dawn, we were on station. The Brits had to be around here somewhere. I have a visual contact dead ahead, 35 degrees up. Send a signal. Confirm ID codes.
They're well within range, but I'm receiving no acknowledgement, Captain.
Those are Vals. Sound general quarters.
Small wake to the northeast. Could be a periscope.
Houston's too vulnerable. She has no depth charges. We can't engage. Only a destroyer can knock that suit like that.
Bang on!
$1,000 for that island and RV with the Brits.
Where in God's great ocean are the damn Brits? Hold up, I think that's them dead ahead of us. Send a signal. This is the USS Houston. Is anybody reading me? Repeat, USS Houston. Any ears?
Copy, Houston. This is HMS Hotspur. Glad to have you here.
Looks like you got your hands full, Exeter.
I'll say, Commander. This is just the vanguard of a Japanese battle group led by the Haruna, a Congo-class battleship. She's been gaining bearings since we passed the Sunda Strait.
Well, let's help you mop up here, and then we'll see about the big boys.
Thank you, Commander. I believe you are the ranking officer. My ships are at your disposal.
Smokestack sighted, sir. Headed our way.
Looks like the Haruna's caught up with us.
What's the plan, Commander Walker?
The Haruna outranges and outguns any ship we got. Torpedoes are the only chance we've got of putting her under.
Your sense of timing, Nautilus.
In the end, it became an RV you wouldn't wish for. After the battle, I was recalled to Pearl on the personal authority of Admiral Nimitz.